Hello everyone, I'm Jana Smakula. Welcome to another Spellbinders video tutorial. In this video, we are creating a beautiful foiled cards using products from the Glimmering Hot Foil Gift Set. So the Glimmering Hot Foil Gift Set includes several different products. Basically, you have everything you need to get started with hot foiling. You have a Glimmer hot foil system and also several products, several Betterpress plates, along with foils and paper and even clear sheets to help you get started with your foiling. I'm going to create a simple foiled card and I will walk you through the process. So here I have my Glimmer hot foil system. It is already nice and hot, and I'm going to foil the Anemone Blooms Betterpress Blade in one of the foil colors that comes in the kit. I'm using my Spellbinders scissors to cut a piece of foil large enough to cover my Glimmer plate, and then I am placing a sheet of specialty Glimmer cardstock on top and adding the two plates, the two shims that are included with the Glimmer hot foil system. I press the timer button and now I just need to wait for about a minute for my Glimmer hot foil plate to get hot and ready to transfer the beautiful foil onto my paper. I'm going to use the Glimmer hot foil system together with the Platinum 6, and the Platinum 6 is going to apply the pressure. The Glimmer is providing the heat, and then the Platinum 6 is providing the pressure. So it takes about 1 minute for that light to blink, to flash, and for the plate to get good and hot. Now that the light has turned solid green, I can take the platform out of the docking station and slowly send it through my Platinum 6 die cutting and embossing machine to apply pressure and transfer the beautiful design onto the paper. Let's remove the foil and take a look, and oh my goodness, see how beautiful this is. Foiling always gives such beautiful and unique results. Next, I'm going to do some ink blending. With this Glimmer plate, you can leave it as is, or you can add color to it using your favorite coloring medium. I'm going to add ink blending using Betterpress inks and Spellbinders blending brushes. I have three colors of ink: Taffy, Tuscan, and Tiger, and I'm going to use the small blending brushes in different sizes. So these particular blending brushes come in a pack of three, and there is a small, a medium, and a large brush in each pack, giving you options and allowing you to add ink blending to even the smallest areas. So I'm first blending with the taffy ink. I actually had some leftover ink on my brush. I tried to clean most of that onto a piece of scrap paper. And now I switch to a smaller blending brush and I'm picking that same ink up again with a smaller blending brush and applying it to the tips of the petals. So I want to fade the hot pink into white. The base of the petals is going to be hot pink, and then the tips of the petals is going to be white. This is a very easy process. I'm not doing any masking. I'm just using the small blending brushes to apply the ink onto the paper. If you want to be very particular, if you want to be very specific and very careful as to how you apply the ink, you can also create a mask for this image. So foil this same image once again, cut it out, create masks for the individual petals or for the flowers, and use those masks to apply the ink. I didn't want to do this. I wanted to do simple ink blending, and I wanted to show you how you can quickly add color to this beautiful image. I'm going to speed up my ink blending just a bit because we don't want to watch me ink blend for 10 minutes. And with the taffy ink blending done, I'm going to move on to my next flower and my next color. I then came back with a larger blending brush and blended all of that together. That just helped soften the edges of my ink blending and spread the color a bit further. Next, I have a black Betterpress ink, and I'm using a very small blending brush, and I'm applying that black just to the center of my flowers. So these are anemones, and anemones usually have a black center. That's why I'm using the black ink and that tiny blending brush to apply black just to the center of my flower. I'm also using my finger a little bit and then even a dry baby wipe to sort of wipe some of that ink away. And next, it's time to ink blend our second flower. And here I'm starting with a medium-sized blending brush from Spellbinders. I already have some yellow ink on the blending brush. So I'm laying down the background color here. This is that same Tuscan color. And with that done, I'm switching to the smaller blending brushes and applying the ink onto the petals, making sure that I have saturated tips or saturated bases of the petals, and then the tips remain white. So again, I have a lot of color at the base of the petals, and I am fading that color into white. It's one of my favorite ways to do ink blending. Once again, I'm going back to the larger blending brush and softening all of that blending. Again, using BetterPress black ink and a small blending brush and ink blending the center to create the beautiful anemone. For my final flower, I'm using the Tiger ink and once again, a different blending brush so that I'm not contaminating the colors. And I'm adding just a little bit of blending again at the base of that beautiful bud. I'm not going to use any other colors because we have the leaves here and the leaves are all solid, so there's no need to add any other color to this ink blending. I love the way this looks. So this glimmer plate comes with a coordinating die, and here I have my Platinum 6 die cutting and embossing machine. I'm positioning the die on my image and using the best ever craft tape to tape it in place and send it through my die-cutting machine to cut it out. And look at this beautiful floral cluster. Love it. Okay, let's go ahead and start working on a sentiment for our card. So here I have another panel of the specialty BetterPress cardstock, and I'm going to add some color to this using, once again, BetterPress inks. So first, I wasn't sure which color I wanted to have as a background, and I decided I'm going to use the same colors that I used for ink blending my flowers. So I'm first ink blending a background with Tiger ink, and I'm using the largest Spellbinders blending brush. This one is super large and fluffy, and it makes it's very easy to add color to any background. So here I have that beautiful tiger color, and I'm also going to ink blend one more panel using the taffy ink, just because I'm not quite sure if I want to have that yellow orange or if I want to have a pink background. I end up using the pink one because it makes more sense for this card, but I definitely save the other background in my stash to use for other projects. So here I'm just using a heavy hand to apply a lot of pink to my background. With that done, we are going to go back to our Glimmer Hot Foil system and start foiling. So here I have the sentiments. These are included in the Glimmer gift set. And once again, I'm going to cut a piece of foil. This is the same foil color as I used before. And I'm going to foil these sentiments on the pink background. I'm doing the same steps as I did before to foil this image on the paper. If you are new to the Glimmer Hot Foil system, I encourage you to check out a Glimmer bootcamp on the Spellbinders YouTube channel. This will teach you the tips and tricks of hot foiling and will help you become a hot foiling pro. So my sentiment panel is ready and I have quite a bit of overfoiling there. I wanted to share a little trick with you to help remove the excess foil. So whenever I have overfoiling, there are several ways you can use to remove the foil. My favorite method is to use the best of a craft tape and just gently tape it over the foiled image, maybe rub a little bit with my finger, and then lift the tape up, removing the extra foil. You need to be careful and gentle when you do this because otherwise you might remove the actual foil that you actually need on your paper. But if you are careful, you will be able to remove the overfoiling very easily from your paper. Other ways, other methods are to use a sanding eraser, and also you can use a dry brush and just brush the excess foil away. And sometimes you might even use a craft knife to scrape the foil away. When I'm using this particular paper, I prefer to use tape because that, I think, gives me the best results when it comes to removing excess foil. So here you can see all of that excess foil on my tape. And here's a look at our foiled sentiment panel. And then you can also tell that my foiled image now looks a lot better and a lot cleaner. Here's a little close-up. There is a coordinating die available to help you cut all of these sentiments out, and that's the beauty of this Glimmer Sentiment set. You can foil a bunch of sentiments at once and also cut a bunch of sentiments at once. You can save the sentiments you don't need and don't use for a later project, and this way you will have sentiments ready the next time you are making a card. I find this to be very convenient. Remove the coordinating die and just pick the sentiment that I want. I really like the one that says sending love. So this is the sentiment I'm going to use for my card. I love this wonky banner shape. And I'm just going to trim the little loose hairs from the edge of the banner. This is the nature of the paper that I'm using. This particular paper will give these, you know, loose hairs, and you can get rid of them using scissors or even a nail file. With all the parts and pieces ready, it's time to assemble our card. Here, I also die cut a word friend. I use the Spellbinders Treasured cardstock for the top layer of the friend die cut. The friend die is included with the Anemone Glimmer plate. So you have a glimmer plate and a die. So I use the gold assorted pack to die cut the word friend. And I also die cut the word friend two more times from scrap white cardstock. I'm going to use Barely Art Glue and glue these together to give a little bit of stability, a little bit of dimension to this piece. This die also cuts a shadow layer for the word friend, and this is very helpful because the shadow layer helps this little dainty word stand out from the background. And for that, I used regular white cardstock, and again, I cut it from white cardstock twice because I want this to be a little bit sturdier. So going to use Barely Art Glue, and again, glue these together. And then add the friend, the gold friend, on top of the white shadow friend. So the sentiment for my card is going to say, friend sending love. I have a gray panel for my card. This is the Spellbinder's Fog. And I'm going to adhere this panel onto a few panels of scrap cardstock. I like to do this again to make the panel a little sturdier and also if I want to pop it up. So I'm using thin foam adhesive squares here. I'm adding quite a lot of squares to the back of this panel. And I'm going to use those to pop the panel up on the background. So this is an A2 card base. Made from white cardstock, I'm adding a gray panel on top. And next, I'm going to add a little bit of splatter. I have a lot of shine and shimmer on my panel, but I figured I wanted to add a little bit of the gold splatter to this background to add some movement to my card. So here I have the Yasutomo watercolor. You can find this in the Spellbinder shop. It is absolutely fabulous product to add little splatters to your projects. I added a little bit of water using the Spellbinder's water mister, and now I'm using Bastura craft tape in the narrow width and taping the edges of my white panel. I should have just added the splatter onto a gray panel before adding it onto a card base, but I didn't think about that at the time. So that's why I used the Bastura craft tape to mask the edges. I'm also using a water brush and I'm picking up the splatter using the water brush, next tapping on the water brush with my finger and applying that splatter onto the background. This is my favorite way to add splatter onto my projects by using a water brush. Now let's go ahead and assemble everything. So here I have my anemone die cut. I'm also adding it to another panel. A white cardstock panel just to make this die cut sturdier. I'm going to set it aside and let the glue dry and then use foam adhesive squares from the back. These are the regular thickness. So I used thin foam adhesive squares before and now I'm using regular thickness foam adhesive squares to pop this beautiful image on my background. I always like to use foam adhesive for my projects because I like to have a lot of dimension. I feel like dimension helps bring images to life and they just look a lot better in the end. So let's place this in the center of my panel like so. And next we can add the friend die. I'm adding this using foam adhesive squares also, again, to have this popped up on my card. And with a friend die get added, I'm also adding the sending love banner. The sending love banner also has foam adhesive on the back. And again, this is popped up. Everything has a little bit of dimension on my project. And I just love the way this turned out. So once again, this card was created using the Spellbinders Glimmering Gift Set available in the Spellbinders shop. There are many different gift set options and I encourage you to check them out and give them a try. So here's a look at the finished card. I love the way this turned out. Thanks so much for spending time with me today. Love you guys and I'll see you again soon.